jobs in our city, in our community of even out valley and Rosemont area.
All right, so our learning targets that we will be talking about today are how and where are drugs being abused? Why is this a major issue? And what can we as students and in our community do to help?
So some key vocabulary is abstinence, which is restraining oneself from indulging. Addiction, which is being dependent on a substance, thing, or activity. And then withdrawal is the physical and mental symptoms that occur after stopping or reducing intake of a drug.
Okay. So the Eastview statistics at the school went around and asked people questions about what they thought about drugs. And based on the statistics we got, people actually thought that alcohol was the main most used drug in America, when it actually it is tobacco. And over 50% of people have at the schools actually smoked weed, so it's pretty bad. And most believe that weed should be legal in the school. 80% of people at the school said that. Again, more than 50% have never taken non-prescription drugs at the school, which actually is pretty good considering that most top two drugs there are used at the school.
All right, so some statistics for locally, like here in Minnesota. According to the MN student survey, 31% of males have used marijuana, and 24% of females have used it as well last year. And also exposure to LSD, reported the poison control from 2012 to 2013 for our grade as juniors, 11th graders, keeps increasing every year since 2012 to around 2016. And also 41% of 11th grade males and 42% of females have drank alcohol in the past year and have reported it.
Some national statistics are the illegal drug intake for the past month for 12 plus years old across the nation was at 9.4% of the people surveyed. And then that number rose from 2003 when it was 8.3%.
Some statistics about more, not just the United States, but more of like the globe. It is said that one out of 277 people have a drug problem in this world. And based on this graph, the number of problem drug users has been pretty constant throughout the years, with only 27.1 million people throughout the 7.5 billion people in the world.
All right, so kind of a broad question that we are trying to answer is, like, how are drugs an issue? And why are they an issue? And so, drugs like affect a person short-term and long-term. Some of the short-term effects are people can develop a dependency on the drug that they are taking, and they become reliant on the sort of high that they get or the pleasure that they get from the drug. And another short-term effect would be impaired judgment, such as like blurred vision or kind of the lack of common sense that you can And you can also get severe anxiety from taking drugs, and you're always feeling nervous or scared about different situations and how to handle them because your judgment is all blurred.
Some of the long-term effects are bloodborne viruses, respiratory illness, problems with job security because your employer does not want you to be a drug addict, obviously, and a lot of places drug test. And then struggling relationships with your friends and family as they're worried about you and what you're doing with your life.
Okay, so we interviewed Officer Clients at the school, the local police officer, and one of the questions we asked them was what drugs are most present at Eastview and in the community. say that the most drugs that he's seen in this community were actually marijuana and prescription drugs, both which are harmful drugs to take. Marijuana causes memory loss, and prescription can kill you if used wrong.
So also with Officer Plants, we asked him what's the impact that drugs have on students. And he told us that in the past couple of years, drugs have become an even more like driving issue and a bigger issue. And he said that as an officer, this is what he's wanted to kind of help the students with. And he said he's noticed that kids are being consistently late to class, grades are dropping, stuff like that, and or not even showing up to school. And he said it's very hard to see kids doing this because it's not what school used to be like. And he just wants to, like himself, he wants to try to help and prevent it, just like the only ways he knows how to.
And then we also asked, what does he and the police department do to respond to and prevent drug use? And so his main points were that the police department partners with different organizations in the community, and they make different events like the mob crash to spread awareness. And then also, when there is drug use in the school, he tries to connect the users to the counselors at the school and do things like that to try to get them on the right track.
All right, so I interviewed Jody Ellingson. She is my youth director at my church. And so she leads our youth group. And so in high school, she was addicted to a bunch of different drugs for like all 4 years of high school. And she went through treatment as well. And so this taught her a lot of things about herself and gave her a way to relate to students that have been doing drugs or have gone through the same things that she has gone through. And so it allowed her to understand why kids use drugs, because she understands like the pain and why, and the pressures of society, and like the reasons why kids feel the need to take drugs to get away from it all. And it just gives her a way to, you know, help them. And I asked her what are some effective ways to help, and she said honestly the main way for any of kids to get help is for them to get caught first, because getting caught can teach kids who are doing these drugs or alcohol or anything illegal like that, it can teach them the consequences and punishment for doing so. And another effective way that she said is to have positive support from your family and your friends, or people that you know can be there for you in like your struggling times. And I also asked her how has overcoming addiction changed her life, and she said that it made her stronger as a person, and that kind of more compassionate towards others, just more understanding, and that she's kind of more thankful for her friends because she didn't think that they would be there for her when she thought they'd be kind of disappointed in her for doing drugs and making these terrible decisions. And and it kind of opened her eyes to the reality of drugs and how big of a big of a scope of a problem it is.
So now we have our determinants. So our risk factors are academic failure and having friends or peers who use illegal substances. Those can both drive people towards drugs and addiction.
All right, so some of our determinants, we got two protective factors, and one is to have clear expectations regarding drug use, and the other is knowing the potential risks of substance abuse or use.
And just some